What really happens to your organs when you don't eat for 7 days? Most people think fasting is just for fat loss, but that's only scratching the surface. Because when you go long enough, fasting can actually repair the very damage that food has been causing for years for so many people. 24 hours isn't enough to repair that damage, to unlock all of those benefits. The real healing of the organs, though, starts when you go much longer. So I'm going to walk you through exactly what happens to your organs during a prolonged fast and how to get the maximum results without hurting your body in the process. And make sure you stick around until the end, because what happens when you start eating again is probably the most important part. It's where a lot of people lose all the hard-won progress. Now, when people think about fasting, they picture their stomach being empty. But the first organ that actually feels your fast isn't your stomach. It's your liver. That's because it's in charge of keeping your blood sugar steady when food isn't coming in, which is a never-ending job until you fast and you give it a break. Between meals, the liver releases stored sugar to keep your brain and your muscles running. So it's constantly storing sugar, and it stores fat all day as you eat food. And over time, it turns into a warehouse that's packed full, stuffed with all the sugar, the fat, and all the toxins, everything we've been feeding it. But fasting changes that completely. When you stop eating, no more food deliveries come into the warehouse, and you finally give your liver a break. At first, for about the first 24 hours, it can live off the stores, what it already has stored up. The stored sugar is called glycogen, and each gram holds several grams of water. That's why the scale drops fast during the first day, because your liver is causing you to expel a bunch of water as it burns through your stored glycogen. Now, it might be exciting to see the scale drop so quickly, but keep in mind, it's just water weight. You're not tapping into fat quite yet. Then by around day 2 or day 3, those storage tanks are empty and your liver has to change jobs, which is where the real transformation begins. Instead of saving energy, it starts making it, pulling fat out of your belly, your hips, even the fat stored inside the liver itself. And it converts it into a clean, steady form of energy called ketones. These power your brain and your heart without the crashes that come from sugar. You can think of sugar like coal and ketones like jet fuel. Your body is going to perform much better on the jet fuel. This is the moment when your body officially becomes a fat burner. And it's the liver leading the charge. That means it's no longer the warehouse. Your liver is now a power plant. And that's a big deal, because the liver is the most overworked organ in your body. It performs over 500 critical jobs. It filters more than 250 gallons of your blood every day. And when it finally gets a break from storing sugar, fats, and toxins, you see all sorts of benefits show up, like steadier sleep, deeper sleep, steady energy, better mood, and even better skin. Next, when fasting really starts to take effect around day 3 or 4, one of the first organs to benefit from that switch is your brain. In the first few days, when you stop eating, your brain isn't very happy about it because it's used to running on sugar. So when blood sugar drops in those early days, you can feel tired, you can feel foggy, you can feel irritable. But that's just your brain saying, hey, where's my quick fuel at? Then your liver steps in to help, and it starts creating a steady supply of energy from the stored fat, the ketones that we just discussed. That clean energy powers the brain better than sugar ever could. Then as that new fuel builds up in your system, your brain starts to adjust and you experience the benefits firsthand. You might notice that your focus improves, your cravings might calm down, your brain fog finally starts to clear. A lot of people describe a sort of mental calm and clarity that they haven't felt in years during their first prolonged fast. Then by day 4 or 5, your brain is running purely on ketones, which means it's using less energy to think, your mood evens out, your motivation starts to rise, and the longer you stay in that fat-burning state, the more efficient your brain learns to use the new fuel. So the benefits just get stronger even after the fast ends. Next, when people think about fasting, they rarely think about what's happening inside of their gut. But that's actually where some of the biggest healing is taking place. That's because much like your liver, your gut is constantly working. Every meal you eat sets off hours of digestion, breaking down food, absorbing nutrients, keeping harmful bacteria out of your bloodstream. That's exhausting work, and it almost never gets a break. But when you stop eating, that workload drops fast. And by around the second day, your digestive muscles slow down, allowing your stomach and your intestines to just finally rest, Once that happens, your digestive system starts repairing itself, and the gut lining, it's a thin barrier that protects you from toxins, that layer begins repairing tiny cracks and inflammation that have built up over the years. And as that healing starts, the bacteria in your gut also begin to change. The sugar-loving species that thrive on junk food lose their food supply, and they begin to die off. And by day 4 to 5, the healthier bacteria start to take over, the kind that help digestion with real food, making vitamins and strengthening your immune system. That way, when you eventually eat again, that shift really pays off. Your body absorbs nutrients better. You feel less bloated. And your immune system, which mostly lives in your gut, becomes a lot more effective. For most people, this shows up as easier digestion, fewer cravings, less heartburn or bloating, and more consistent energy throughout the day. If you're enjoying this one so far, be sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Doing that helps this information get to a lot more people that need to hear it. And I'll make sure you see more of these videos in the future by doing that as well. Now, if there's one organ that takes a beating from the way most people eat, it's the pancreas. As many of you already know, the pancreas is the organ that controls blood sugar. And every time that you eat, it releases insulin. That's the hormone that helps move sugar from your blood into your cells for energy. When you're eating from the moment you wake until bedtime, that insulin switch never gets a chance to shut off. And over time, that causes your cells to stop responding to insulin the way that they should. The pancreas has to pump out more to get the job done. And that overwork eventually leads to something called insulin resistance, which makes it harder for your body to burn fat, harder to control cravings, and way easier to gain weight. But during a prolonged fast, that system finally quiets down. And by around day 3, insulin levels fall to some of the lowest points they've been in years. As insulin levels drop, your body also becomes more sensitive to it again. That means it can move sugar out of the blood faster and more efficiently when you do eat, creating a cascade of benefits, including better heart health, less body fat. And some early research even suggests that prolonged fasting can help the pancreas regrow a small number of its insulin-producing cells, but only if you fast long enough to give it a break. One of the biggest fears that people have about fasting is losing their muscle. It's a fair concern because your body will use muscle as a fuel source when there's no other food available. And when you're doing prolonged fasting, you're deliberately depriving yourself of food. But the reason losing muscle is such a big deal is because it doesn't just mean you become weaker. It means your metabolism slows down, which can start a vicious cycle of more muscle loss followed by more fat gain. The fact of the matter is that the more muscle you have, the more calories you burn, even when you're resting. That's why protecting your muscle during fasting is so important. So the question is, if you go on a long fast, are you going to lose muscle? In the beginning, during the first 24 to 36 hours of a fast, your body is still adjusting. It might use a small amount of protein from muscle just to keep blood sugar steady. And that sounds scary, but that's just temporary because right around day 2, your hormones change. Growth hormone, the same one that helps build and protect muscle, starts rising. And your liver begins producing steady energy in the form of ketones from fat. Your body no longer needs to pull from the muscle at all. This is your body's built-in survival system. It knows fat is the long-term fuel source, so it protects muscle and burns stored fat instead. Then by days 4 through 7, something even better happens. Your body starts cleaning out old damaged proteins inside the muscle. In a process called autophagy, it recycles those materials to build stronger, more efficient muscle tissue. That's why many people, when they finish a prolonged fast, they're feeling lighter, tighter, and more energetic, not weaker. However, the key is what you do after you finish. When you refeed, it's important you give your muscles the raw materials they need. That means clean proteins, healthy fats, and foods rich in fiber, because your muscles will soak up nutrients like a sponge right after fasting. So no, is my answer. Prolonged fasting doesn't destroy your muscles. It actually protects them, and it draws from your fat stores instead. Next, your heart might not seem like it's part of your metabolism, but during a prolonged fast, it's actually one of the organs that benefits the most. That's because for most people, the heart is constantly using sugar for fuel, which burns fast and dirty. It spikes blood sugar and inflammation, forcing the heart to work harder to keep up. But around day 4 of a prolonged fast, once it starts running on ketones, like the rest of your organs that we've already discussed, high blood sugar and inflammation start to subside. And all of a sudden, your heart doesn't need as much oxygen to pump the same amount of blood. You might actually feel the shift happening. Your heart might feel steadier, breathing a little bit easier. And some people even notice that their resting heart rate drops as their circulation improves. Then at the same time, inside your arteries, another major change is taking place. As sugar levels fall, inflammation in your artery walls begins to calm down. That makes those vessels more flexible, helping blood flow more smoothly, which means blood pressure starts to normalize. And by the end of a week-long fast, your blood also becomes cleaner. Triglycerides, the fats that can clog up arteries, they start to fall. And your HDL, the good cholesterol that protects your heart, often rises after you break your fast and start eating again. That's assuming you're eating the right foods. Now, one of the wildest discoveries about prolonged fasting is that it actually regenerates your entire immune system from scratch. Around day 5 to 7, your body starts recycling old, inefficient immune cells, the ones that can cause more harm than good. And it starts using the spare immune parts. It frees up resources for brand new immune cells once you start eating again. Then when you refeed, your bone marrow goes to work. It produces fresh, healthy white blood cells. They're stronger, more efficient, and better at knowing when to attack and then knowing when to rest. That's why so many people who do prolonged fasts also notice less joint pain, fewer allergy symptoms, faster recovery when they do get sick, and just an overall lighter, cleaner feeling in their body. Now, we've reached the most important part. When your fast ends, your body isn't just ready to eat. Every organ is waking back up, waiting for its first real signal of what comes next. After 7 days without food, your system is clean and it's sensitive. Every organ, your liver, your pancreas, your gut, your muscles, your heart, operating on a blank slate. Think of it like high-performance engines that have just been rebuilt. So what you put in next determines how well it runs. During the first 24 hours after eating, everything begins turning back on. The liver starts refilling its glycogen stores, but at a slower, healthier pace. You don't want to overload it at this critical time, so give it simple, natural foods, broths, vegetables, healthy fats. Avoid refined carbs or sugary foods that instantly push it back into storage mode. The pancreas also starts releasing insulin again, but after a week of rest, your cells are now more sensitive to it. That means even a small sugar spike can hit harder than before. So ease in carefully to prevent dizziness or bloating. The kidneys also begin pulling sodium and water back into your body. This causes the scale to rise by a few pounds. It's okay, it's normal. It's just hydration returning, not fat gain. So no need to freak out. Then over the next 2 to 3 days, your body begins rebuilding. The gut starts reseeding itself with new healthy bacteria. You want to feed them fiber, leafy greens, fermented foods. Again, avoid processed foods. Those feed the wrong bacteria. Your muscles also begin soaking up nutrients like a sponge. This is the perfect time for clean protein, chicken, fish, eggs, beans, clean protein powder if you need. Just don't have one with added sugar in it. The protein helps strengthen your metabolism and rebuild any tissue that was cleaned out during the fast. And when you do this right, you'll feel it almost immediately. Your energy stabilizes, digestion gets smoother, sleep deepens, your skin often looks cleaner, a sign that your liver stayed clean. But if you rush it or reach for junk food, your body reacts fast. Within 24 hours, insulin can spike higher than it was before the fast. Within 48 hours, fat can start building back up in the liver. And within just a few days, the bad gut bacteria you worked so hard to get rid of can start taking over again. All the hard work your organs just did can unravel in a weekend. So think of refeeding as the final stage of a fast, not the end of it. Because the first few bites you take decide whether your body keeps healing or slides right back to where it started. Now, if you want to keep burning fat longer after your fast is over, then I highly recommend, right, you start learning regular fasting for shorter periods of time, especially after your prolonged fast is over. You get this part of a habit for your lifestyle. Talk about intermittent fasting. There's a lot of different ways you can do it, but out of all of them, one has been scientifically proven to work with your natural circadian rhythm of your body. It burns more fat, improves your blood sugar more, and it crushes your cravings better than any other option out there. I walk you through everything you need to know about it in my free night fasting guide. I will put a link to that guide below. Inside it, you will learn the exact eating window that trains your body to burn fat while you sleep. It's going to give you the best foods, even some recipes to eat earlier in the day to unlock overnight fat loss, and how to time your last meal so you wake up in the morning leaner, energized, ready to go. You've already done the hard work learning what happens during a to prolonged fasts, now take the next step and make fasting part of your everyday lifestyle. So grab a free copy of the Night Fasting Guide using the link below. I'll show you how to keep your body burning fat even while you sleep. Now, there's one more thing you need to see, because the wrong fasting habits can undo every bit of progress your organs just made. In my other video, I reveal the top 7 fasting mistakes that can slow your metabolism, trigger your cravings, even reverse fat loss. One of them makes your body up to 4 times more likely to binge when you finally break your fast. And another can actually make your metabolism drop by 50%. You've already done the hard work healing your organs. Now make sure you don't sabotage it. I will include a link to that video here. Click it to watch it next, and I'll see you there.